Oh man, I am gutted. I don't know what to tell you guys. I
Yeah.
would have liked anything else just to call Len yesterday. Be like, you know what? I am going to take that Memorial Day off. What do I need to do this for pride for? I'm really only doing today's show
Yeah.
for pride because I'm
Yeah.
just like, he's like, you guys gonna work Memorial Day? And Leroy's no, like, no, rats off a ship.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, if it goes six or seven, I'm gonna do it just because it's the honorable thing to do. You
Yeah.
know, I'm gonna do the radio show and I'm gonna react to the Heat season. You know, and I was so confident
Yeah.
after quoting Miley Cyrus and seeing one of the greatest performances on a basketball court I have ever seen in game six from Jimmy Butler that I failed to realize that not only could they lose game seven,
Yeah.
but lose it in the most gut-wrenching fashion
Oh man.
ever in person. I just sat there numb, just like, oh, it's over. It's over. It's that's how it's gonna go down, huh? And I'm on like 2 hours sleep.
Yeah.
I cried myself to sleep last night. And you know, here I am for pride.
For
This is what I'm here.
pride.
I'm here for pride. So let's have it, everybody. Let's do a radio show and talk about this season, which was a hell of a season for the most part. It really was. You know, you get to game seven and you know, you are inches from going to the NBA finals, and somehow, you know, magically the NBA's wiping points away. I don't know how that's happening. I mean, the moment where Mike Biamonte gets on the PA system and goes, ladies and gentlemen, we have an announcement to make. That 3-point shot from Max Strus, you know, from like
Oh my
15
God.
minutes ago,
Holy crap.
no good. 3 points away. What?
Has that ever happened?
Oh.
I've never in my life seen 3 points be taken away so long after.
I've heard it happen like at halftime where they've been
Yeah.
like, oh, hey, that three that happened, that was a two. You know, something like that. I've never seen anything like that where they're in the midst of a run and they're just like, you know, that run that you guys are on? Nah. And then here's the thing with being boots on the ground. The angle that I was on was probably the worst angle to see because it's in the corner, like all the way
Opposite
down the
side.
aisle. So I'm just like, oh, I just see the ball go in. I had no idea where Max Strus was. But people are looking, they're like, yeah, that was pretty close. Like, normally, if something happens like that, I would think it has to be egregious. It has to be awful. And
For
they
sure.
show what goes down with Max Strus, and it's like pretty questionable.
I'm still
Pretty
not sure.
questionable. Pretty questionable for them to take that point, those points away. And you just think about the run. You think about the end of the game. You think about the Jimmy Butler three. You think about all of that stuff. And you're like, man, I can't believe that is going to loom so large over a game that decides who goes to the mother bleeping NBA Finals. And look, could I be a petulant child today? Could I sit here and say that, let's be real about it, the free throw discrepancy, the utter mood of this entire series has leaned Boston Celtics. Could I sit here and say to myself, fix was in. They were going to do, this was WWE. They were going to do whatever it took to get the Boston Celtics to the NBA Finals if it was within their power. And they took that huge shot in the first quarter, got off to a huge lead. He closes the gap at halftime. And you come out, you immediately get cooking with the run. And they're like, nah, never mind. Bump, bump, bump. Ladies and gentlemen, we have an urgent and important announcement. No Strus 3-pointer for the Heat. It's crazy to me. I don't know. I
Never
could
seen
be.
that. Never
I
seen
guess
that.
I guess I gotta be no excuses, right? That's what Eric Spoelstra says. No excuses. Even though yesterday he seemed quite broken about it after the game. He goes, you know, I guess he was. I guess we'll be the case study. Case study.
Yeah.
It's great. I guess, you know, I guess somebody's got to be the lab rat. And why not be the lab rat when you smell a rat when it comes to a series? So
how does Al Horford never commit a foul?
I don't know, dude.
How is that possible, dude?
I don't know. It's amazing. It's amazing. Guy's a wall, I guess. Hit the ID here, Marcos.
The Ticket is the home of every Miami Heat game. WAXY South Miami and WSFS HD2 Miramar. An Odyssey station.
And the headlines are brought to you by the new Palmetto Ford Truck Super Center. Why buy your truck at a car store? Palmetto Ford, we know trucks. So, official score, 196. Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals. Boston Celtics, they are moving on to the NBA Finals to take on the Golden State Warriors. Jason Tatum, he is your Larry Bird most valuable player of the Eastern Conference Finals, even though it should have gone to Jimmy Butler, to be honest with you. I saw one guy voted for Jimmy Butler. First of all, there's only 10 votes. 10 votes. We had 10 people that only picked these awards. One guy voted for Jimmy Butler. So he was incredible. I mean, Jimmy was so good. That game 6, first of all, was so legendary with what he did, you know, with this team needing every bit of those 47 points to will their way to a game 7. He was such the man and did it in front of all those chowder heads in Boston, which, by the way, I had the most annoying Smurf behind me yesterday. I guess it would have been a Solette or a Murfette. She was so annoying. Oh, it was just a twist the knife a little deeper yesterday. But that performance by Jimmy Butler was so incredible. And then in game 7, to give you everything that he had, 48 minutes, played the entire game, gives you 35 points, 9 rebounds. And, you know, people are going to sit here and they're going to be mad at Jimmy Butler, or they're going to question Jimmy Butler for taking that 3, going for the win. And I just don't know how you could do it. I mean, I logistically get you saying, be like, oh, we only needed a 2. First of all, this game and this series, quite frankly, was so physical, such a throwback. Bodies are laying by the wayside. There's no PJ Tucker. Lowry can barely move. Tyler Hero, you know, it was a nice thought that he was going to be dressed. He couldn't really play. You know, so the Heat are basically playing six guys. And Jimmy Butler, who's been the best player in this series, thinks to himself, I'm going to go for the win. I'm going to go for the mother bleeping win with 16 seconds left. And he did. And he was a little short. I know he's not. You go there and you got to go down with that guy. If that guy goes and wins you a game with a 47-point masterpiece, and you guys seem like you're dead, you kind of pull this last run out of nowhere. Max Strus hits an incredible 3 to bring you within 2. You get the stop. And yeah, very early into the shot clock, there's, you know, it's basically, you know, no time has run off, like 5 seconds. But he was wide open. That's the look he wanted. I got to go down with Jimmy in that one. I got to. And with how good he was playing over these last 2 games, and his 3-point shot being better, quite frankly, just hit 4 3-pointers the game beforehand, I'm okay with it. He's your guy. This is what you do. You go down with your superstars. You know, if he goes and he tries to get to the basket, ties it up, all right, who knows how much time you're going to take off, first of all. You know, could he wind it down all the way and just go for the tie? Yeah, but then you're going to an overtime where, again, basically no bodies left. Everybody's already exhausted as it is. Guys are playing 40-plus minutes. That's what he went with. I'm okay with it. I'm going to live with it. I'm going to live with it being okay with it that Jimmy Butler took. If somebody else took that shot, If it was Victor Oladipo, okay. I'd be like, don't know about that one. If it was somebody else, Gabe Vincent, I'd be like, all right, I don't know about that one. Even though Gabe, I do trust Gabe from three. If it was Kyle Lowry, I'm like, all right, well, I guess that's why you brought him here. But no, man, Jimmy Butler, with how he was playing this entire playoffs, carrying you, doing everything for you, I got to be okay with it. It hurts. It hurts. That's all I feel today. You know, somebody actually had a great point of me on social media where they're like, because I said, you know, it was a hell of a season, but it's just pain right now. And he goes, it's not even pain. It's numb. I said, you know what? That's a better word. I'm numb. I'm numb because I can't believe it's over. I can't believe it's over. I can't believe the Heat lost three games on their court. But I'm also thrilled that they had such an epic game in Boston to get it to this point. So we will take you up until 10. If you guys want to hit us on Twitch, we are streaming there, twitch.tv/790theticket. You guys can text 786-360-0790. Those texts and the ticket are driven by Kendall Toyota and West Kendall Toyota. We'll take some Heat calls today. Marcos can let me know who's on the line there, and we will get to some of your Heat calls as well. Same number, 786-360-0790. We're streaming on the Odyssey app, AUDACY. So if you guys are going to be sitting your ass in bed today, you're going to be prepping for your barbecue, you're going to get us on your run over to Publix to get some last-minute hot dogs or hamburgers before you grill, great. We'll be here with you for 4 hours, and you can listen to my pain. And I just want to say, if you are tuned in today at WEI, which I think it would be too early and unbecoming of you to be doing that, laughing at my grief, I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, go to hell. That was crooked.
Exactly.
15 minutes of pain here for you on 790 The Ticket. Beautiful montage there, Marcos, of game six, because it's the one thing that sucks when you do this show and you have a game like that. You kind of want to celebrate it with all of your listeners and all of your audience. It was that epic. And it kind of goes from, you know, epic to, you know, legendary and in lore forever if the Heat ends up winning this series. And sadly they don't, you know, they come up just short yesterday in game seven. It was an electric atmosphere. It was so cool to be in the building for a game like that. You know, between everything that was going down with having to get downtown to be Memorial Day weekend, it being a monsoon, everybody was there. It was a vibrant atmosphere in FTX Arena, and Jimmy Butler was awesome. And you know, Spo is a great thing that he says about Jimmy Butler, where he just says that he's the ultimate winner who just hasn't won the ultimate prize yet. And I just don't know how you can't just give this guy all your love and support as a Heat fan. And it's a little bit strange because he has come here at a point in his career where he had plenty of years in the books already. He was already on three different teams and, you know, clawed his way up to Chicago Bulls. And then you thought he was going to be on the team right after the Timberwolves thing, and then ends up going to Philadelphia. And everybody tells him he's crazy for coming here. Everybody scoffs at the idea of him coming here. And how dare he pick Miami over the great city of Philadelphia? You'll never be loved in Miami like you are in Philadelphia. And I just don't know how this guy's not one of the most beloved all-time Heat players, even though he, you know, this is a franchise that prides itself on the standard of championship. This guy has given you such great championship quality seasons. He is giving you such iconic performances in series. And yeah, they've been performances that have kind of gone toe to toe and has ended up with him being just short. But you also know that, man, he's also done this with an empty deck as well, because his point guard, his running mate there, Kyle Lowry, basically had like one more good performance left in the playoffs that he was able to physically push himself through, which he did in game six. And he was a gamer yesterday, you know, but just so clearly just wasn't what he was even in game six. You know, he fell over at one point and they had to call timeout because he just couldn't physically recover from getting up and doing what he had to do. And so I feel bad for Jimmy in that regard, because this is a guy who got to the NBA Finals, statistically outperformed LeBron James, got two games with a teenager and Kelly Olynyk as his running mates there, because Bam had one arm and was out for half the series, and Goran Dragic missed basically the entire series. And now you think about this series, and, you know, yes, Boston was dealing with stuff too. Okay. Marcus Smart and Robert Williams were questionable basically throughout the series, missed some games throughout the series. Al Horford missed a game from health and safety protocols. So, yeah, there was stuff that went both ways. But, you know, let's be real about it. By the end of this game, you got PJ Tucker couldn't play anymore physically. Physically just worn down. Couldn't give him anything more. That's PJ Tucker, as tough as they come. Kyle Lowry hobbling all over the place. Tyler Hero, much like Goran Dragic in that game six, you know, he was out there, but 7 minutes. He really wasn't out there. They kind of threw him out there. Hey, maybe he'll give us a spark. And Jimmy's doing this with basically getting Victor Oladipo, giving you 33 minutes. The guy was limited to 15 minutes just a couple of months ago. And so he does get a really, really great game from Bam Adebayo. Bam does show up in a game seven. He gives him 25 and 11. Really was cooking Al Horford by the end of that thing and looked great. But it's this guy has just been everything you want a Heat player to embody. He embodies. He gives everything he physically has. You know, he also wasn't 100% in this series, and he was the best player in the series. You know, they end up giving that stupid Larry Bird trophy to Jason Tatum. Jason Tatum wasn't the best player in this series. He had a great game yesterday. Nah, he's not a bum. I don't want to say he's a bum. He's a good player. He's good. But wasn't the best player in the series. No way. No way, dude. No way. No way, no how. Jimmy Butler basically single-handedly won two games and was a three-pointer away from winning three. Just straight up basically by himself. And it is strange. It's like, you know, Boston is dealing with their own journey. They're calling it their revenge tour because, you know, they have Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum and Marcus Smart. That little core there has been together, and they've been through a lot of heartache. And they got them from drafting and all that type of stuff, this whole growing up that they've had to do. And the Heat have had Jimmy Butler for three seasons. But, man, it's been an incredible three seasons. And I even include the season with Milwaukee. We're getting swept by Milwaukee in that, because that might have been Jimmy's, you know, best statistical individual season. MVP. And that, again, was just like quick turnaround. We saw what happened to all those teams that were in the bubble that had to turn around. They all kind of ran into the ground. And you see what the Lakers doing. You know, they won the championship, yes, but they have not been the same since that bubble. And everybody called the Heat bubble frauds. And Jimmy Butler had them inches away from being back in the NBA Finals. And I hope Heat fans appreciate that, because we've been very spoiled down here as a fan base with, you know, Dwayne Wade and the Big Three being down here and those guys getting you to a ton of finals, three championships. And, man, Jimmy Butler's just been unbelievable. He has just been you see the names when you see a game six like he had and facing elimination, that it tops LeBron James. Who would have thought he's going to top LeBron James? 45 points in Boston facing elimination. And he does that. It's he's just been everything you could ever hope for in a player coming to your city, the team going as he goes, getting better in the playoffs than he is in the regular season. And, you know, people always sit here and they want to debate, oh, superstar, what's his status? I don't even understand how this is a question. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You think about all the players around this league with them not playing basketball, or they're unhappy where they are, or all this belly aching that goes back and forth. You know, oh, go, here's Bleacher Report. Watch Kyrie Irving cook. It's like, all right, dude, bounce in the first round like he is every year when he's not playing with LeBron James. Never know when he's going to play basketball. You fawn over the guy. Kawhi Leonard, who's awesome, never plays basketball. Nobody seems to question with him. You know, he's a rusty rim away from not beating Jimmy Butler in a playoff series. Maybe Jimmy Butler never comes to the Miami Heat. But nobody seems to question Kawhi Leonard. You know, why Jimmy Butler has to continue to prove himself and prove himself and prove himself for people to even like say, oh yeah, you're kind of on the fringe. Bullcrap, dude. This guy is bar none one of the best players in the league. He is unquestionably a superstar and has given the Miami Heat everything in his three seasons here. And one of them was in the finals, was the best player in that series. And one of them here was the best player in the Eastern Conference Finals. You come up just barely short. And it hurts, man. It hurts. You know, I'm trying to have like a positive outlook today because I just kind of was just, it was just such a gut punch feeling that in the building last night. I know everybody else who was there is feeling the same thing. I know everybody who's watching on TV is feeling the same thing today too, because it's funny, man. My wife was like, she was watching the game. She's like, I'm going to watch the game. You know, my wife doesn't watch sports. She's not.
She looked locked in yesterday, though.
She was locked in, dude. She was locked in. We're sitting there texting back and forth throughout the game. And she's hurt, dog. I'm like, this is sports.
Yeah.
This is what it is. Like, you could have been part of, she wanted to be part of the party. The unfortunate thing you don't realize is the gamble is this could also be epically painful. And and that's what it was. So really was one of the probably like what the most crushing game in that building since Allen Houston, you know?
Yeah, I was gonna say, I haven't felt this way in a while.
Just a straight up moment. Like, it's pretty awful watching Dallas. I was at the game where Dallas, I watched Dallas celebrate the championship.
Yeah.
Game two also where the Heat were celebrating and then blew it. But, you know, you did start feeling the swing of that Dallas series. Like, this was like, no, somehow, some way, you felt like even with everything going against them, corruption and taking points away, corruption with free throws, everything going Boston away, everybody dying for Boston to win this series, still felt like they were going to find a way. And just comes up short, man. Just comes up short. I will get to some of your reactions on the other side. I've done enough selfish rambling. So I will get some of your texts. 786-360-079 if you want to text or call. I'll take some calls as well if you guys want to go dial us up here. I'm with you till 10, going the full day here on a Memorial Day. Did not want to skip out on today because it's a fresh wound, and I think we'll all try and make ourselves feel better by the end of this thing. And you know, probably not. I'm lying to you. I gotta be honest with you. This is gonna hurt for a long time, like really, really bad. I'm not watching the NBA Finals. You guys can go to hell. I'm not. Don't.
Not
don't,
1 second.
I'm not watching a second of the NBA.
Not Finals. One
if
second.
If you think for 1 second I'm staying up to watch that, you can go straight to hell. Back after this.